गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द न्यू चैप्टर इन द बिजनेस स्टडीज इन पार्ट ए, दैट इज द डायरेक्टिंग. ओके, सो फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द मीनिंग एंड इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट ऑफ द डायरेक्टिंग. सो डायरेक्टिंग फंक्शन ऑफ मैनेजमेंट इज मेनली कंसर्न्ड विद गिविंग द इंस्ट्रक्शंस, गाइडिंग एंड मोटिवेटिंग द एम्प्लॉयज in the organization. So what is the need of giving the instruction to the employees? That is motivating the employees. It is very important for every organization in order to achieve the organizational goals very effectively. Okay, so after the staffing, we studied the staffing function. No, that is, what is the staffing? That is placing the right person in a right position in the organization. But actually the works begins only when this person gives the instructions, that is getting the instruction from the superior. Okay, so after the staffing function, the work begins only when the certain employees getting the instruction from the superiors. So directing does not mean only the instructions, but it also includes supervising the employees to perform when they are performing the job. So supervision is done by the superiors, and motivating the employees to do the work, to perform the work more effectively and efficiently, and leading them to achieve the goal of the organization. Okay, so this is the main function of the directing. The next one, we are going to see important features or characteristics of directing. The first one is the directing initiates the action, that is other functions prepare the base or the setting of the action. That is, directing initiates the action means how the action has to be carried out, how to start the action which is planned by the superiors. So by giving the directions and instructions, the manager get the work started in the organization. Okay, and the next one is directing takes the place at every level of the management. That is called as the pervasive function. We already studied in the other function of the management, no? So directing is also the pervasive function because it is performed by the managers at all the levels in all the locations. So every manager from the top executive to the superior performs the function of the directing, and every manager has to supervise and he has to guide and he has to motivate and communicate with his subordinates to do that work in a proper manner. Okay, so the time which is spent in the directing is comparatively more at the operational level of the management. So directing takes place wherever the superior subordinate relationship exists. Okay, that is the direction. During the directing function, the managers from the top level to the lower level is coming forward and they are performing the job to achieve the goal of the organization in an effective manner. Okay, and next one is the directing is a continuous process. Directing is a continuous process. That is, a manager cannot just rest after giving the orders and instruction to the employees. So only by giving the orders and instruction to the employees, it is not the thought for the managers that the work for the managers comes to an end. That is not the meaning. So by giving the orders and giving the orders and instruction to the employees, the manager is more responsible and he has the work to that is guiding the employees continuously, and he has to supervise and motivate the subordinates continuously in all the functions of the business activity. So he must continuously take important steps to make sure that orders and instructions are carried out properly or not. So only directing is the continuous process. Okay, and next, directing flows from top level to bottom level. That is, the directions which are given by the managers to the subordinates, and every managers can direct his immediate, that is, the subordinate, and takes the directions from the immediate boss. So directing starts from the top level and flows to the lower level. Okay, so see the diagram. That is the flow of information. So from CEO, the information passed to the executives, and from the executives to the middle managers, and middle managers to the supervisors, supervisors to the employees, and employees to the customers. This is the flow of information. So it has the direction starts from the top level to the and flows to the lower level. Okay, and next one is, it is the performance oriented also. So other characteristics of directing are, it is the performance oriented. Directing is the performance oriented. So the main function of the directing is bringing the efficiency in the performance which is done by the employees. So directing converts the plan which is created in the organization into the performance. So performance is the very important element of directing. Okay, so directing function directs the performance of the individuals. How to direct, how the directing is directing the performance? Only through the achievement of the organizational goal. Okay, and it is also the directing function also involves of studying the human behavior and molding the human behavior in a proper manner. So it involves, that is, the directing involves interpersonal and intergroup relationship between the superior and subordinates. Okay, and it is playing a very important role to motivate the employees to work with their best ability to achieve the goal of the business concern. Okay, so these are all the important characteristics of directing function. What is the first one? That is, directing initiates the action, and it is a continuous process, and directing takes place at every level of the management, and directing flows from the top level to the lower level, and it is a performance oriented, and it is very helpful in improve the human behavior between the superior and the subordinates. Okay, next topic is, what are all the importance of the directing? Okay, the first one is, directing is very helpful to initiate the action by people in the organization towards the attainment of the desired objectives. So what is the first one? It is important is the employee in the organization, that is, to initiate the action which is planned by the superiors. So the employees in the organization start working only when they receive the instructions and directions from the superiors. I'm right. So in the directing function, the superiors direct the actions of the employees towards the predetermined goal of the organization, that is, which is already planned. The goal of the organization is determined by the superiors in the organization. I'm right. So through the directing function, they will direct the actions of the employees towards the goal of the organization. Okay, and next one is, it is facilitating the introduction of changes in the organization. That is, generally the employees hesitate in accepting the changes. I'm right. But through the directing function, the changes can be implemented more easily. As while giving the direction, the superiors guide the subordinates that the changes are better for them also. Okay, generally that is somewhat, if after giving the directions, the managers are coming and changing their plans, and they are communicating the changes to the employees frequently, means that it will be very hard for the employees to complete the work. Okay, because they are planning their activities, and they have started the activities with the previous plan. But if the changes is happening frequently, means it is very hard for the employees to complete that particular work. But through the directing, if it is properly directed, if it is properly directed by the superiors to the subordinates, then it is very easy for the employees to accept the changes. Okay, for example, when the company is planning to computerize its working, generally the employees hesitate to accept it because they are not aware of the technology, how to use the computer, the technologies and softwares. But when it is the directing, but it is used in the case of directing function, the employees are guided that through the changes they will also be updated of learning the new technology through by providing certain training to the employees by the highly professional experts. Okay, so through the training they can able to learn the technology. So it is very helpful to accept the changes and implement the changes in their activity. So through that is the directing is very helpful to, and it is making the work for the employees in a proper manner, even if there is a changes in the business environment. Okay, the next one is the effective directing helps to bring the stability and the balance in the organization. So the directing brings the stability and the balance in the organization. So the directing function tries to create, that is, the directing function is playing a very important role to create the balance in the organization. What is the balance between the attitude, that is the attitudes? So for each and every employees there is a different attitudes. So when the employees are working at the different levels, they develop the different attitudes and the balance between their attitudes, which is made by the directing function. For example, if the salesman may insist on reduction of the price to get more orders, whereas the high officials are against the reduction of the price, I'm right, so it will bring down or reduce the total revenue. If there is any the misunderstanding between the salesman and the high officials, so in the directing function playing a very important role by bringing the balance both the attitudes of the higher levels official and also to the employees by instructing and guiding the salesman, by instructing and motivating and guiding the salesman to find out other means of factors and other ways of increasing the sales or revenue. Okay, so sometimes there may be the differences of attitude between the employee and the employer also. In this case also, the directing function playing a very important role to create the balance by instructing the employees that their interest and organizational interest are in the same direction. That is, creating the balances by instructing, by giving instruction to the employees that their interest, employees' interest as well as the organizational interest, or in the same direction. So it is very helpful. Directing function is very helpful and it is playing a very important role in bringing the stability and balances in the organizational activities. Okay, and some of the principles of directing are maximum individual contribution. This principle emphasizes that directing techniques must help every individual in the organization to contribute to his maximum potential for the achievement of organizational objectives. So the directing is playing a very important role, and this principle is very helpful for the individual in the organization to put his 100% effort, that is the maximum potential, maximum effort to achieve the organizational goal. Next one is harmony of objective. What is the harmony? We already studied. We find that individual objectives of employees and organizational objectives are understood as conflicting to each other. So good directing should provide harmony by convincing that employees' rewards and work efficiency are complementary to each other. That is, the individual objectives. What is the individual objectives? That is to complete the work within the particular time, which is created as the target for the employee, and right, and to achieve the organizational role. That is the basic common objective of the individual who is working in an organization. But some of the individual objectives of the employees and organization objectives are as understood as a conflicting. So some of the misunderstanding, some of the employees will work as in their own interest without considering the organizational goal. But through the proper directing, okay, it will create the employees, and the superiors can able to convince the employees that the employee reward and the work efficiency are complementary to the each other. To each other means that is the individual objectives as well as to the organizational objectives. Okay, that is the harmony. Next one is unity of command. This principle insists that a person in the organization should receive the instruction from one superior only. So unity of command is the another principle of directing. So in this principle, that a person in the organization should receive the instruction from the only one superior, that is the unity of command. Next one is techniques. According to appropriateness of direction technique, so according to this principle, appropriate motivational and leadership techniques should be used while directing the people based on the subordinate needs, capabilities, attitudes and other situational variables. So this principle is very helpful for the superior to motivate the employees. And some of the techniques, what is that, leadership techniques should also be used while directing the employees. Okay, which is based on the subordinates. What is the need of the subordinates? What is the capability of the subordinates? What is the attitude? After learning all these factors, it is very helpful to make the employee more comfort to do their work in a proper manner. Okay, the next one is managerial communication. What is mean by managerial communication? The effective managerial communication across all the levels in the organization makes the direction more effective. So definitely that should be the proper communication skill, communication between the superior and the subordinates. So only if there is a proper managerial communication factor, which is a very important factor and very important principle in the directing, it is makes clear instruction, that is clear instruction which is instructed from the superior to the subordinates. And only if there is a proper communication, it will create a good understanding between the superior and the subordinates. Okay, and through the after instructing and giving proper instruction, guiding to the employees, and if there is any feedback from the superior, the managers should accept that feedbacks, and he should come forward to understand the feedbacks which is created by the subordinates. It is possible only through the proper directing function. Okay, and next one is use of informal organization. What are the use of the informal organization? So the managers should realize that informal groups or organization exist within every formal organization. So there is a two types, formal and informal. Okay, he should spot and make use of such organization for the effective directing. So the next we will study about what is the types of that is the formal, what is by formal, what is by informal organization. So when we are choosing that informal groups or a formal organization, he should be very thorough in selecting or making use of such organization through the effective directing. It is very helpful for the effective directing. Okay, next one is leadership. What is the leadership? While directing the subordinates, the managers should exercise the good leadership, as it can influence the subordinates positively. That is the main. But it should not be the order. The order, it's also the order with a positive manner. So leadership is a very important role which is to be played by the superiors in a proper manner with a positive way, which without causing the dissatisfaction among the employees. Okay, and next one is follow through. That is, giving of an order is not the sufficient. Manager should follow it by reviewing continuously whether the orders are being implemented accordingly or any problems are being encountered. So after giving the instruction to the employees, the managers should come forward. They have to work and they have to follow the employees whether the instructions are conveyed properly, and they have to review continuously with the employees whether the orders are implemented accordingly, as per the orders, whether they are working or if they are working in some other way. So that should be the proper supervisor, and they have to follow the employees. And if there is any problems, they have to identify the problems which is created between the employees. Okay, so if there is any problems, so if there is any need of changing the that is the plans, so there is suitable modifications should also be made through the directing function. Okay, so these are all the important principles of directing. The next one is, what are all the elements of direction? So there are four important elements of directing. First one is supervision, second one is motivation, third one is leadership, and fourth one is communication. So these are all the four important elements of direction. So today we finish the meaning and protection part of the directing. Some of the important features or characteristics or a scope or nature of directing function, and importance of directing function, and some of the important principles of directing function. So in the next class we will start what are important elements of directing. Okay, thank you students.